Welcome back, everybody. I'm really excited about this particular video. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the five things that I've learned about being around wealthy people. They have certain things that we all would love to learn. It's kind of like the cheat codes, right? So I'm going to be sharing with you guys the five things that I've learned about being around wealthy people. Okay, so let's get right into it. The power of influence, right? Wealthy people like being around other wealthy people, and they like to challenge each other. They understand that you're a product of your environment. They understand that in order for you to grow, you got to be around other people that are willing to grow. Let's say, obviously you guys know I'm Mexican, but let's say I was, you know, 1 year old and I was dropped off in China. I guarantee you that by the time I was 8 years old, I'd speak Chinese because I'm a product of my environment, right? So teachers or parents, a lot of people don't really tell you the importance of influence, right? And not to underestimate the power of influence. We're always being influenced, not only by the people that we're around, by what we listen to, what we feed ourselves, by what we're reading, but what we're watching on TV. If you're constantly watching CNN, right? Constant negative news, you're most likely gonna have a lot of negative thoughts. But if you're constantly getting around successful people, right? Motivating yourself, listening to these type of videos or personal development reading, you're obviously gonna have the right mindset. So definitely number one is being around other successful, other like-minded people that are growing consistently, right? Number two, they value their time, right? They understand that the most valuable asset that we have is time, because that's something that we can't make more of, right? No matter how wealthy you are, you can't buy more time. They don't really waste their time. They know exactly what they're doing really throughout the day. They have things planned out because they understand that time is so valuable, right? Those precious moments with those loved ones, and they don't want to get distracted just, you know, watching binges of Netflix. Not saying that they're all completely bad, and we all do it. You know, I'm guilty of it, right? But they understand that they can only do that a small percentage of the time, and they'd rather be enjoying their time with family. They'd rather be growing their business. They'd rather be working on themselves, because time is the most valuable thing that we have. They wake up early, right? They have their own miracle morning routine, right? So that's a book that I highly recommend, The Miracle Morning. When I was growing up, obviously for like a lot of people, I would love to sleep in, right? And I say, man, I'd love to sleep in all the time. But what I found out very quickly as I got older is that if I wanted to get ahead and I wanted to really get around, you know, start going to success levels, you know, that I wanted to get to and things that I wanted to achieve, I needed to start getting up a little bit earlier, you know, whether that's 7 a.m., whether that's 6 a.m., whether that's 5 a.m., that's 4 a.m. I remember just recently I went to a conference to somebody that wakes up like somewhere around 3 a.m. every single day. And I could tell you, he is super sharp, and between 3 a.m. and probably 11 a.m., he gets more accomplished probably than what most people accomplish in a week, because you're just so sharp, right? And the power of the mind, we only have so many quality thoughts throughout the day. So if you're waking up early, you're gonna have a lot of really high level thoughts, and you're able to attack the day in the early morning, right? Number four is they join masterminds or groups where they all talk about how they can become better in whatever endeavor or whatever thing that they're looking to do, right? Whether they're looking to grow spiritually, right? Bible study, whether they're looking to grow in their business, grow in their relationships, whatever the case may be. They have masterminds that sometimes you have to pay a lot of money to be a part of. Sometimes you have to pay $5,000, $10,000, $15,000. But I can tell you guys that masterminds is kind of like the cheat codes with video games. I guarantee you that it'll get you from point A to point B, you know, so much quicker, maybe in 5 to 10 times faster than if you were just do it on your own. I definitely, after my first year in real estate, I joined masterminds right after my first year. And that's something that I set as a goal. I said, you know what, I want to invest, you know, $10,000 in the course of a year in masterminds or whatever the case, because I know what it's going to do to me. So number four, join masterminds. And then the fifth one is committing to never ending personal development. Right? That's something that we're never going to stop doing, is growing as a person. I know that, you know, the most successful people that I know, they're so much more developed, you know, as far as in all their aspects, because they're always growing. They're always going to conferences. They're always growing books. And for a lot of people, you may be going through a situation that you think is a huge problem, but I'm telling you what, no matter what you're going through, somebody has gone through something similar, and there's been a book about it, right? How to get your credit on track, how to start saving more, how to start investing better, how to start reading better. I mean, how to become a better reader. There's a great books on how to do that. So no matter what, I encourage you guys to start picking up books. And at the end of this video that, you know, I want to recommend, I think some of the top three books that I would highly recommend to get your 2022 started the right way, that are books that I would read 10, 20, 30, 40, hundreds of times. And these are books that I think I'm going to continue reading until I pass away, because every single time you get something more out of it. Every single time you have a better understanding, right? You can't read a book once and think you're going to master it and think you're going to learn everything from it, right? So the top three books that I recommend getting started, and some that I just really highly recommend, is number one, The Magic of Thinking Big by David Schwartz. Great, great book that'll help you just blow your mind and really help you understand how to think bigger, right? So I would read that book, and it's a really easy book that you can probably read in a matter of a few days, if not in a matter of one day. So The Magic of Thinking Big by David Schwartz. Number two, probably one of the most recommended and the most read book in really business and for a lot of different things, is Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. I mean, this is a classic that has sold millions upon millions, and still to this day is impacting so many people. I mean, Think and Grow Rich, what it basically is interviewing the most successful people, like Henry Ford and, you know, Rockefellers, and what they did and what they're doing and what they had in common. And you kind of find out that there's a lot of similarities and things that you want to learn that the wealthy and the super successful do, right? So Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill, I would definitely recommend to pick that up. The same thing, you can finish that book in the matter of a few days or in the matter of a day. Number three, The Compound Effect by Darren Hardy. It kind of helps you understand that little increases of getting better just by 1% a day, just by reading a couple of pages a day, just by drinking a little bit more water a day, just by eating less, you know, sugars or bad things a day, has a huge increase in the matter of a day. And you know, as I'm recording these videos, I want to help you guys understand I'm growing on this journey with you guys. I'm definitely not perfect. As you guys can see, I have definitely work that I'm doing for 2022, and definitely health and health is wealth, and that's something at the top of my priorities, and making sure that I have a good routine, that I'm starting to eat a lot of vegetables, a lot of fruits, and having a good successful 2022. Because what good is it if your brain is wanting you to get up, but your body is not, right? Your mind is telling you to get up, but your body can't, because you're not giving it the nutrients and the things that you wanted to give it. So I hope this this video has brought a lot of value to you guys, and those videos really help you guys out. Tell me what you think. Tell me what books you guys are reading in the comments below. If you haven't already, if you like this content, make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit the notification icon. Share it with somebody that may be able to help. So thank you guys, and we'll see you guys on the next video.